Hello and welcome. In this video, we will guide you through the creation and configuration of an email sending service using the SMTP protocol. We will see how the application is structured and how different components are used to send text emails, HTML emails, emails with attachments, and much more. We use MailKit instead of the standard .NET library for SMTP, as it offers us more flexibility and advanced features, such as full support for modern authentication, like TLS and SSL, secure connections, and better error handling. Join us as we break down each part of this process in a simple and practical way. We start by configuring our project. To configure our project and the default values for our mail server, we enter the AppSettings file. And we configure our server, our port, our user, password, and if the connection to our mail server requires SSL connection or not. SSL refers to our plain text connection. For port 25, no SSL connection is used. Plain text authentication is used if required. In our example, we are not going to have user or password authentication, so we are going to leave these fields empty for configuration. After storing our configuration in the app settings, we will proceed to create a new class, where we will store the configuration that we are going to use in our program. This configuration is going to have the same fields and values as the configuration file. So we're going to have our server, our port, our users, and our password. Also, whether or not SSL is going to be used for authentication. After this, since we are going to use dependency injection, we are going to add the options so that they are globally accessible from any part of our application code. By adding them via configure, the options will be loaded directly from the app settings file and loaded into our class to be used later in our program. After this, we are going to create our service. So, to get started with this, we add in our NuGet package manager, our dependency, which is MailKit. We search for our MailKit package installer, accept the settings, and now we create a service that we can call it SMTP service. With this service, what we are going to allow is to send emails from anywhere in the application, so we can inject it later in our controllers. So we enter our service and add the option, the configuration options that we had previously created, and we inject them directly into the class constructor through eOptions monitor. What iOptions monitor is going to allow us is that if the configuration in the app settings file changes, this configuration will be able to be loaded again without having to restart the application. We created our method to send the emails, which will receive a MIME message type parameter that will be in charge of having the content of the email, and through the SMTP client, we will be able to send the emails using the MailKit library, replacing the standard .NET library. We are going to connect, by default, we are going to connect through port 25, which is the standard for email without authentication. If our configuration does not contain a username or is empty, we will skip authentication and then proceed to send the email. Then, in our program file, we inject our SMTP service so that it is accessible from any controller. We are going to create an example controller that is going to be called Email Controller, where we will be able to handle all the requests made to our program. So we start by creating our service and injecting the SMTP service, as well as the options. We do not need to inject the options. We are going to inject them in this example just to verify the operation and verify that the injections are loaded correctly. Our first method that we are going to implement is getsmtpoptions, which will return the current configuration of the mail server. Next, we'll add our root, injecting email controller into our root and calling the function. Then, we'll proceed from our browser, consulting the full root we made. There, we'll be able to see our current server configuration and what the user, password, and whether it's SSL or another type of configuration have. thanks to using eOptions Monitor. We will be able to modify our app settings file, and we will be able to check in real time that the configuration has been modified in our software, updating only the web page without having to restart the application. Likewise, when we restore it, it is immediately applied in the next request. Now we are going to proceed to create a function to send a basic email. Our basic email is going to be a plain text email where we are going to create a function called sendAsync, where we are going to have our message of the type MIMEMessage. We are going to select from whom the email is going to be sent and to whom the email is going to be sent. From the mail that in our case is plain mail text, the plain text will arrive and we will return true. This field is simply to consult in the controller. It has no value, nor is it symbolic for our case. We are going to use general values. We create the route to send the email and then we execute our mail. On our test server, where we use the paper cut application, we can check the email that arrived, the recipient, who the email is from, and we can check what is in plain text. Then we are going to send an email in HTML format. We are going to create our send HTML async function, which will allow us to send an email with the same parameters as the previous one, only changing the body of the email, where we are going to send the HTML type text format, and we will be able to send our email in HTML format. It is important that this HTML is not a full version of HTML. Many email clients have restrictions on what HTML can be used. For example, scripts cannot be used, there are different types of styles that are allowed, and many restrictions. It is necessary to check with the different types of email clients which ones are most compatible. Standard or basic HTML is usually compatible with this. So, with this HTML, we will be able to give a better tone, a better image to our emails, so that they look more professional and add images, layout, and styles. After this, we add our route in our controller and verify. We verify the sending of the HTML email and it arrives perfectly in HTML in a header. In our next method, we are going to send the same HTML email and plain text. So we use the same headers as before, the same from, the same to, and then we add our title and we are going to make a new body type for the email called bodybuilder. In the bodybuilder, there is the HTML version, the HTML part, and the text part. This text and HTML part will be sent together in the email. The HTML part is for browsers and email clients to allow us to view a nice, stylized version of the emails. The text part is mainly used for email clients that have HTML disabled for security reasons, privacy reasons, or for notifications that arrive in emails. Normally, notifications that arrive in email clients are text-based. They use the plain text version to display in the preview. Therefore, these two messages do not have to be exactly the same. They can be different. So, let's make sure that in the text body part, we add a description of the email or a general summary of what we want the customer to see without the need for layout. We add our route and check the operation of the email. Here we can see that by default it previews in HTML. But if we look at the content of the email, the sections have a plain text version and they have an HTML version. Both should arrive correctly. We will add an attachment to the email. To add an attachment, we will use the same bodybuilder body type. From the previous function, where we are going to have our HTML part and our plain text part. On top of that, we are going to use the attachment object, where we are going to add the file name and the file content into a stream. For our case, it is a plain text file. Normally, we can use images, PDFs, or other type of document that we need to send as an attachment. We create our route to test our sending of attachments. We send our attachment and verify that it arrives correctly. All parts of the email arrive, the plain text part, the HTML part, and our attachment, which in our case is a TXT file. Now we are going to add headers to our emails. We are going to use the same components of the email from the previous part, only now in our headers part, we are going to add a header that is very similar to the HTML headers, but for email. There is a header that is very important called list and subscribe. This list and subscribe is mandatory for email clients like Gmail for the notifications or mailing lists that we use. If we are sending a distribution list or notifications without this header, Gmail will block the email or it will go to spam directly. So with this, we make sure that the client gets a URL that will be consumed when the client clicks on the unsubscribe button. This URL does not have any content. It should just return a 200 status in the HTML, and the user will not see the full graphical interface. They will simply be unsubscribed from the list without having to access the page or continue or fill out any form. This is done so that the user will be automatically unsubscribed from unwanted mailing lists. We proceed to create the route to test our headers. Then we create our route, check it in our browser, and then in our email, we can see the different headers that the list has. We review the headers where we will be able to check that our subscription URL arrives correctly. Finally, we will learn how to send a calendar. In our mail, this is important for our agendas and to send reminders to users. We will have to add through the package manager, the package called iCal.net. This package will allow us to create events in calendar format. Then we will get a function where we will get our calendar, where we will indicate the start date, the end date, what type of event we have, who are the event participants, who is organizing it, what type of alerts will we receive, 15 minutes before, 5 minutes before we will receive an alert telling us that our event is taking place. And we are going to add this event to our email. So to add this event to our email, what we have to create is a new type of body or email body that is going to be a multi-part. Then our multi-part is going to be a mixed type in which we are going to add the part in HTML, the part in plain text, and we are going to add a new calendar type part in our email, which is going to have a new content transfer encoding that is going to be base 64 instead of plain text. Also, we are going to add the request parameter. With this parameter, we are going to indicate to the user that we are asking them to accept or reject our invitation. We add our route to send the calendar to test the calendar. We run our URL. And we found that the calendar arrived in vCalendar format. It is a vCalendar attachment, but email clients parse it and add the notifications that the user requires so that he can consult it. In this video, we have learned how to build an email sending service from scratch using MailKit to handle a wide variety of email scenarios. We saw how to send plain text, rich HTML, mixed text, emails with attachments, and how to add custom headers to improve the user experience. We also explored the importance of calendar invitations for better organization and team communication. We hope that this guide has provided you with a solid foundation for implementing effective email solutions in your projects. If you have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments and subscribe for more content.